إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه إلى يوم الدين يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار ثم أما بعد. All praises due to Allah. We seek refuge with Allah from our sins and bad deeds. He who is guided by Allah indeed has been guided. And he who is misguided, only Allah Azza wa Jalla will guide him. And the best words are the words of Allah, and the best guidance of the guidance of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran al-Kareem, وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِاللَّهِ هُوَ مَوْلَاكُمْ نِعْمَ الْمَوْلَى وَنِعْمَ النَّصِيرُ اعْتَصِمُوا, it's a command by Allah. اعْتَصِمُوا بِاللَّهِ, hold on to the way of Allah, unite with the way of Allah, as individual, as groups, but اعتصموا as individuals, beginning, and then groups, and then nations and societies and so forth. But it starts with the individual. You hold on to the way of Allah. هُوَ مَوْلَاكُمْ, He is His caretaker. He is the only one who's taking care of you. Nothing that happens except by the will of Allah. Whether you want what happens or not, it will happen. Whether you try to prevent it, if it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala willing it to happen, you will not be able to prevent it. And if you want to accomplish something and Allah will prevent you from accomplishing it, you will not be able to do so. But the way of Allah is the way to hold on to the way to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to the book of Allah and the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is your caretaker. نعم المولى ونعم النصير. The best, he is the best of caretaker. And he is the best of the one who gives victory. Okay, he is the one that takes care of things, and He is the one who gives you victory. It is all from Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, throughout the Quran, tell us what to do tell us how to do it, takes care of us and give us good news about those who are doing so the way of Allah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell us what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to do when you do what you are asked to do. If you do this, Allah will do this. It's a promise. It's a promise from the one who created the heaven and the earth, the one who created time that you are working in, the one who created the space that you are working in. So Allah is in control of time, in control of space, in control of everything, and He is the most wise, and He is the most just and knowledgeable. So when Allah promises, the promise comes true. When Allah advises, the advice is for our own good. But, and this is the means of Islam, this is the way of Islam, that to surrender to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so whatever Allah commands and show us how to do it through the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, therefore we go in it with a complete trust that this result that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised will happen. With no doubt, because it is the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with Musa alayhi salam, give Musa alayhi salam a command. In the very early time when Musa alayhi salam became a messenger. Musa alayhi salam was not a messenger for a long time in his life, and now he gets a revelation. Allah talks to him when he was walking with his family after he left Shu'aib and his in-laws, and now he's moving on, and he sees the light. He asks the fire. He asks his family to stay back, and he will go. لَعَلِّي أَتِيكُم مِنْهَا بِقَبَسٍ أَوْ أَجِدُ عَلَى النَّارِ هُدَى. Maybe I'll get you something from the fire, so we can build up a fire here and get warm. Or I find guidance with the fire, meaning find the way, find, you know, directions and so forth, because if there is a fire, there is somebody has to be there. And he got there, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke to Musa alayhi salam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put Musa alayhi salam through a training session to prepare him. The stick that Musa alayhi salam had, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him a command what to do with it. And Musa alayhi salam responded to the command. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Musa, مَا تِلْكَ بِيَمِينِكَ يَا مُوسَى. What is that in your right hand, Musa? Musa alayhi salam said it, هِيَ عَصَايَ أَتْوَكَّأُ عَلَيْهَا وَأَهُشُّ بِهَا عَلَى غَنَمِي وَلِيَ فِيهَا مَآرِبُ أُخْرَى. It is my stick, I walk with it, I hit the tree so the leaves will come down for the sheep to graze, and I'll do other things with it. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives a command to Musa. أَلْقِيهَا يَا مُوسَى. Throw it, Musa. And Musa alayhi salam threw it. That is an easy command to follow. A command that is easy to follow. You have something in your hand and you throw it. Okay, I throw it. The effort is so little. It does not seem like there is a harm in it. And we all do that in an easy way. A command is given and it is easy to do. And yeah, why not? But then it became something different than it was. Now it became a snake, hayyatun tasa, a snake, a great snake, and it is moving around. It is pausing to attack. So now, this is the most scary situation that one could confront. It is the most. The kind of event that happened, or the kind of change that happened, it is the most scary to a human being. One can have explanation to things. Like when in a paper moves, you can explain it because there is some wind around, the window is open, or whatever it is, that's why the paper moved. So maybe you'll be startled a little bit and then you have an explanation for it. You have a stone there that rolls, all of a sudden, yeah, it was maybe off balance and something happened, and now the weight of it brought it down, and so forth. We have explanation to things. So long that the properties of things stay the same. So long that the paper stays the paper, the stone stays a stone. But when something changes in properties, it goes into the heart of a human being. Because the safety that we have in our life that Allah has given us is because one direction of it or one way of it, because we know the property of things that does not change. Okay? So you can walk in your life and know that everything, we walk in this room and you know the ceiling is above us and there is a column in the middle here holding the ceiling up, and we know it is not going to change on us. We know that there is a floor under us and we build it with wood or stone and it is holding us, and the property is going to stay the same. So you go on your life and you do not even think about it. You have a stick, you're holding it in your hand, you have a chair, you sit on it. That is safety is all over, because you know that. So once the property of things start changing and it becomes something else, that is very scary. Okay? So as soon as it became a snake, it changed to become something that is alive. Now something, a stick, a wood, becomes alive and starts moving, and it has a very specific creation now. It's a snake, and it is pausing to attack, and it is so huge. So there is no speculation in the matter. There is no thinking, maybe it's a wind here, maybe my eyes is betraying me here, I cannot see well. No, it is a snake. Musa alayhi salam ran away. The reaction is run away. You would think that there's something like this, you know, you are talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will stand, Allah is there, Allah is taking care of you. But this is with our fitrah. It's a reaction. It is built within us that we would react by shying away, by flight, okay, for such a thing. So he ran away. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him to come back. But now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives another command. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put it, okay, in three sections. خُذْهَا, take it. وَلَا تَخَفْ, do not be afraid. سَنُعِيدُهَا سِيرَتَهَا الْأُولَى, we'll bring it back to the way it was. This is the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaching the prophets, teaching the messengers of Allah, the prophets of Allah, the anbiya'illah, and those who are submitting and surrendering to Allah. A command, خُذْهَا, take it. So what is it? Once Allah said take it, what comes to the mind of Musa alayhi salam? Take what? It's a snake and it's about to attack. So there is, the fear is still there. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَا تَخَفْ وَلَا تَخَفْ, do not be afraid. Do not be afraid. Allah has given advice. It's the command, the advice and comfort, and then the promise. Then the promise. We'll turn it back the way it was. This is our life as Muslimin on earth. Okay? So Musa alayhi salam had to follow to take the advice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and try to work in himself, to not be afraid. And he had to do what Allah said to get the result. The result is not going to happen without the work, and the result is the promise from Allah, and it will happen. So Musa alayhi salam got himself together, and he knew that he trusted Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so much that he knew, even though it is a snake, even though it is about to attack, but he knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also knows that it is going to turn to a stick if I touch it. So he had to work on himself so hard to follow the commands of Allah, and he is certain with the commands, with the promise of Allah, more the certainty of what this snake could do. So his eyes, his ears, his being knows that this is dangerous. But Allah says, no, it is not going to harm. Go and take it, it will be a stick. And he was able to do so. He was able afterwards to go to the Pharaoh, the tyrant on earth, who had a huge civilization, a huge army, and now he's Musa alayhi salam going with a stick and going to the Pharaoh. Yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now promises Musa alayhi salam many promises in the future. But how it is going to happen, Musa alayhi salam does not quite know. The details of how events are going to unfold in history in front of Musa alayhi salam, he did not know it. But he knew the end. He knew what is going to happen in the end. To the point that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked to Musa alayhi salam and his brother Harun alayhi salam, and told them to do something, to how to approach the Pharaoh. Okay? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قَالَ اذهب إلى فرعون إنه طغى فقولا له قولا ليلا لعله يتذكر أو يخشى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, both of you go to the Pharaoh. He transgressed over all boundaries. Go to him and talk to him nicely and kindly. Okay? Nicely and kindly. قَوْلًا لَيِّنًا, a saying that is layin. Layin means soft. Soft here does not mean compromising. We have to understand that. Not compromise. Not making the halal haram and the haram halal, say I'm just being soft. No. Soft in a way of delivery. The way of delivery. Okay? Do not go shout at him and so forth. No, go in a way that is soft. Okay? And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, maybe, hopefully, he will, لَعَلَّهُ يَتَذَكَّرُ, maybe he will remember, أَوْ يَخْشَى, or have some fear. Meaning, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling Musa alayhi salam and Harun alayhi salam that talk to him with the hope that he will become a Muslim, he will believe in you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows in the future that the Pharaoh is not going to believe and he's going to die drowning, and he's going to die as a kafir. See? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching us, you do what you have to do in the environment that you are in, despite of what you think the expectation is going to be. You do not go to the Pharaoh and think of him, this tyrant, he's never going to believe, he's never going to do that, it is impossible for this, so I'm not going to do the work that I should do. No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala advised and did not tell them, just never mind about the Pharaoh, he's never going to believe, just go on. No. Your job is to do the work. And do the work of calling and people in Islam and doing the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is good for the environment and good for you as well, because it helps you to grow. This way of control helps you to grow. So now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminded Musa alayhi salam. When Musa alayhi salam was kind of scared, I'm going to go to the Pharaoh. Okay, Rabbi shrah li sadri, oh Allah, open my chest, his chest is tight now. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminded Musa about events that happened when he was an infant. When he was an infant. So he would know what the reality of things is, not their perception. Not the perception of what's going on. What was the reality? And told him information, and told us information, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, about Musa alayhi salam, that when you go back to it, if you were at the time and looking at this, you'd never think the result is going to be the result that happened. Okay? It's completely unexpected. Okay? But it is the way of Allah. So what happened was the mother of Musa alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised her, commanded her, okay, and put her at comfort and promised her. The same thing. The same thing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in khifti alayhi, if you're afraid something will happen to him, why? The Pharaoh's soldier were coming to kill all the infants. Okay? If you're afraid, فَأَلْقِيهِ فِي التَّابُوتِ فَأَلْقِيهِ فِي الْيَمْ. Throw him in another ayah of أَلْقِيهِ فِي الْيَمْ وَلَا تَخَافِ. Okay? That throw him in the sea and do not be afraid. So here is the mother of Musa alayhi salam getting wahi inspiration that when she becomes afraid, do something which does not make sense. The possibility of the harm of the infant that comes to the infant, to Musa alayhi salam, from the soldier, if they happen to stop and enter her house, it is less, in the possibility is less than the possibility of harm of throwing him in the river, in the Nile. So you're throwing him into, for as a human being, thinking to a probability and possibility of harm is so much, and taking him away from so little. That doesn't make sense. If you are a human being thinking, what are the probability and possibilities and so forth, you'll say, no, I'm not going to throw him in the river. I'm going to keep him and maybe hide him somewhere in the house. No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, again, give the command and said, throw him in the river and do not be afraid. You are afraid now, and you should be more afraid throwing him there. No, Allah says no. Again, the idea of fear. Hold on to that fear in you. Don't trust Allah and throw him in the box and put the box in the river. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised, inna raduhu ilayki. We will bring him back to you. We will bring him back to you. إِنَّ رَضُّهُ إِلَيْهُ وَجَعَلُوا مِنَ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. And we're going to make him from the messengers, among the messengers. So here is, again, a command and a comfort. Don't be afraid. Go ahead and do this. And don't worry. The promise is, he's coming to you. And he's going to be a messenger. And she did. When did Musa alayhi salam come back to her? In a very short days. In just a matter of not even days. In a matter of hours. The matter of hours. The plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala worked. And no one knew what this plan is. But the mother of Musa alayhi salam knew the result. Knew that Musa alayhi salam coming back with no doubt. Knew Musa alayhi salam is going to be a messenger of Allah with no doubt. So, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, moved around this puzzle in history, Musa alayhi salam goes to the Pharaoh, right to the door of the Pharaoh. And how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings the Pharaoh to take Musa alayhi salam through his wife. وَأَلْقَيْتُ عَلَيْكَ مَحَبَّةً مِنِّي وَلِتُصْنَعَ عَلَى عَيْنِي. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes this event of the box going to the shore and going to the door of the backyard of the palace of the Pharaoh. Okay, Allah says, I threw on you, that gives you an impression of what abundance and so much. I threw on you love from me. Love. Here is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to work this event with love. And وَلِتُصْنَعَ عَلَى عَيْنِي. And you will be made over my eyes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that. And you will be made over my eye. He is in the box, in the river, at the Pharaoh said, the Pharaoh soldier ready to kill any infant of the Israelites. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here talking about love. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here talking about I'm making you over my eye. the power of Allah, the power and the wisdom and the knowledge of Allah, and the lack of wisdom and knowledge that we have. We should trust and follow, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of things. The events will unfold, and we take the means and do the best. And we cannot sit and hope for the best, work and trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So now, here is the tyrant, the man who is the leader of a civilization. At that time, never a civilization was like it. He has an army of this, he gives the command, bring all the infants and slaughter them all, and this tyrant. And then, now his wife says, you're not going to touch this, I love him. And he said, yes, ma'am. Done. It is done. And the work of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a promise will happen. Okay? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as he was promising the companions the promise of Allah, this matter will prevail. The matter of Islam. Yes, we are weak in Mecca. The woman will be coming from up north all the way in a camel by herself, and it will be in safety. So the promise that Islam will prevail. No problem. When is that going to happen? What the events that it is going to take for this to happen? It's not quite clear. But the message is there. And it is going to happen. Now, one of the companions of Rasulullah ﷺ comes to Rasulullah. And as Rasulullah ﷺ was reclining next to the Kaaba on the ground. So he comes to Rasulullah, drops his garment, and shows Rasulullah ﷺ his back. He was tortured. And so he's showing his back. Rasulullah ﷺ has all the cuts and bruises and blood and pus and all of this coming from his back. He used to pull him on a burning coal in the desert and so forth. Then he said, Ya Rasulullah, ud'u lana Allah. Oh Rasulullah, ask Allah. So ask Allah for what? To end this period and let us go to the end now, right? You promised us, we know that, but that's enough. Let's go now to the result. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was reclining and he sat up. He sat up, his face sallallahu alayhi wa sallam got red, indication of some anger that Rasulullah said. This is how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mature anger, okay? And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, before you, and Rasulullah talked about the disciples of Isa alayhi salam, of Jesus, peace be upon him, Isa alayhi salam, the companions of Isa alayhi salam. There were those before you that they were put in a hole on the ground and they were sewn from their head up while they were alive, two half. And they used to get iron of combs of iron and iron their flesh off their skin while they're alive to let go with what they have, and they didn't. You, إِنَّكُمْ قَوْمٌ تَسْتَعْجِلُونَ. You are people who want it in a hurry. You are, Rasulullah ﷺ talking to the one who's complaining, you want it in a hurry. No, you have to go through this. You have to prove that you believe in this and hold on to it and do the work. And when you are worthy, it will be given to you. It is not going to be accomplished. It's going to be accomplished by your work to be worthy for this gift of Allah. And at the end you do not say, we did this, no. Alhamdulillah that Allah brought us to Islam. Alhamdulillah that Allah helped us to be standing fast in Islam. Alhamdulillah that we're able to go through all of this. And Alhamdulillah that Allah gave us victory, and this victory and all of this is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did give victory to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the companions. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not leave us, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not leave us without a promise. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Zawallahu li al-ard. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enabled me to look at the whole earth. meaning in the future. Here is the promise. Here is the promise. Okay? Not a house on this earth that is made out of brick or stone or made out of hide, meaning a tent-like, except Islam will enter it. بِعِزِّ عَزِيزِ أَوْ بِذُلِّ ذَلِيلِ. By the dignity of the dignified one and the humility of the humiliated one. In other words, there will be those who are against it, those who are working against it, but they will not help but to follow. Not to follow it willingly, but to follow it because it will be the way of the earth. That is the promise. Could you look at what's happening in the earth today and say, oh yeah, this is going to happen tomorrow? Or when? We don't know. But that is the way. So similarly, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands, gives you glad tidings and comfort, and promises you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us to follow the Quran and Sunnah, to follow the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. نَعْتَصِمْ بِاللَّهِ. To hold on to Allah, to hold on to the rope of Allah. This is our way, this is the command. Okay? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us comfort in this, and give us glad tidings in this. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell us that victory will come. What is victory to a Muslim? Is a victory a Muslim standing and say, I am winning and somebody else is losing? No. The victory in the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you know, you see Hind, the wife of Abu Sufyan, okay, when she killed, paid to someone to kill Hamza, radiallahu anhu, the uncle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then she came and cut him to pieces after he died. This is how much anger and hate she had in her heart. She was the one, eventually, that we take the hadith from her. So we say, you know, Hind radiallahu anha. Now we say, may Allah be pleased with her. She came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She said, Ya Rasulullah, O Prophet of Allah, my husband, his hand is tight. Should I spend from his money without his knowledge for my children? And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave her the permission to get what the need that she can take for her children. So we get the hadith and what to do from a woman who killed the uncle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is the victory of Islam here. The one who was the enemy of Islam became the one who's abiding by Islam, spreading Islam, happy to be a Muslim, proud to be a Muslim. Okay? To be able to do the right thing on earth, that is victory. To injustices, we lift injustice and replace it with justice, that is victory. Okay? To change ourselves, our family, our environment, our nation, the earth, that is the victory. When human being, as individual, as a system, comes up to the best of man in the best of way, that is victory. Okay? So that is our, should be our sense of winning. The way of Allah will prevail with us or without us. And it is our benefit and our privilege to be included in this journey. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأدعوه يستجب لكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين ورحمة الله للعالمين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه إلى يوم الدين ما بعد. الله سبحانه وتعالى promised us through the hadith of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم that the last journey of the history of Islam on earth is going to be khilafa ala minhaj an-nubuwah. Khilafa on earth on the path of prophethood. And before it, it is going to be, or it was, or it is in some places, hukm jabriyyi, that is khilafa, or hukm jabriyyan, that is ruled by force, by iron fist, and that what was going on in some Muslim world, and now it is changing. Now it is changing. And this is when Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم says, تكون فيك فيكم ما شاء الله لها أن تكون. This hukm by force and by iron fist is going to be as long as Allah wishes it to be. Allah is wishing it to be a certain length. ثم يرفعها الله ما شاء أن يرفعها. Now that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will lift it when He wishes to lift it. And if you see the work that the Muslimun were doing in that period of time, the period of the iron fist and the injustices, a lot of work. A lot of work, and you see the result is coming around. And the youth who are holding on, as I was growing up in a Muslim land, I could hardly find a book to read about Islam in the place of Al-Azhar, okay? Meaning in the country of Al-Azhar, okay? And you find any books about any isms, you know, not capitalism, at that time it was Shiu'ism, communism, and so forth, okay? Yeah, it was all over. That is, now the work of the Muslimin was underground, if you will. Now it came on the surface. Now there are results. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala thinks of us somewhat that we started to be worthy. Starting to be worthy. We need to be a sharp tool. So when we are used by Allah, we get the best result. So long that we are rusted and dull, we're not going to get the result. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us and show us the right path and help us to go on it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show us the wrong path and help us not to go on it. Allahumma anta a'lamu bima fi qulubina faghfir lana dhunubana. Allahumma anta a'lamu bihajatina minna faqdiha lana. Allahumma anta a'lamu bisirrina wa ala niyatina fataqabbal ma'adiratana. وصل اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وقوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.